Welcome back to another episode of Eye Care in Focus, where we try to make eye health and vision care more clear for you. Today, we're going to try to figure out why your doctor always does that air puff machine to you every single time you go into their office. Our topic for today is glaucoma. We'll get to the air puff in just a little bit. So what is glaucoma? Glaucoma is a disease of the optic nerve. And everybody has kind of heard that high eye pressure is what causes glaucoma. And while it's not quite that simple in all cases, lowering the eye pressure is the only way to treat glaucoma. So eye pressure is a big part of it. So what are the symptoms of glaucoma? Well, not a whole lot at first, but closer to the end stages of glaucoma, it will eventually get to the point where blindness starts creeping in from the peripheral vision, working its way in until you have tunnel vision or eventually nothing left. In some cases, people will have really, really high eye pressure. It can cause pain, but for the most part, people who have glaucoma have no idea. So here's a picture of the back of my eye. My optic nerves actually look a little bit suspicious for glaucoma. So this is the optic nerve, this big circle here. And you see that smaller circle there, the more yellow one? That's what we call the cup. Everybody has this cup, but mine is a little bit larger than what's considered normal. So this smaller circle is called the cup because it's shaped like, well, a cup. It's just an empty space that goes back into the optic nerve. So the theory is that all this eye pressure building up in your eye is pushing on that space and doing damage to the nerve fibers that are on the outside of that cup, which is what makes them die off, which is what makes that cup get bigger. So here's a picture of an optic nerve that is considered more normal. Here's the optic nerve, and it's really hard to even see that little circle because it's so small. Sometimes it's a little bit larger than that, it can be normal, but like I said, mine is definitely larger than normal. But just because my optic nerve looks suspicious for glaucoma, that doesn't mean that I actually have glaucoma. It means that I need to watch it. So what we wanna watch for is we wanna make sure that this cup is not getting larger over time. This whole part of the optic nerve is called your nerve fiber layer. All these nerves are coming from the back of your eye and traveling out through that optic nerve, kind of like the ponytail on the back of a girl's head. So if those nerve fibers start dying off, this empty space, the cup, in the middle will start getting bigger. But the process of those nerve fibers dying off is the result of glaucoma. So how do we make sure the optic nerve isn't changing over time? Pictures is a good way to do that. We can look at pictures from 1 year to the next to 5, 10 years later. Also, there's a machine called an OCT. An OCT helps us get a measurement of the optic nerve and of that cup. So if a machine is doing the measurement, it takes a little bit of the guesswork out. Instead of human error just going, eh, I think that's changed over time, or I think it's the same. The machine is telling us for sure, this is the size of it one time, this is the size of it the next time. Another way that we can monitor for changes in glaucoma is to look at a visual field test. The visual field test is that one where you look into this big bowl and these lights pop up all up to the outsides. You have to push a button every time you see one of those lights. So if we know that somebody's visual field is normal one time and we repeat it again later on and they have any part of this that's showing a visual field defect, we can assume that something has caused that visual field defect. These are the results that we get after that test is finished. This is a map of the visual field. The dark spot is a blind spot. Now, that one's normal because your optic nerve causes a blind spot. Everybody has these in the back of the eye, so if that's not there, we know you did the test wrong. There are no other defects out here that show us this person has any blind spots. So if a dark patch popped up, let's say, off to this side and kind of came in this direction, or if kind of the whole thing was getting dark to the outsides, we might want to compare that to previous visual fields and see if that's a change. Another thing that we like to monitor when we're testing for glaucoma is the eye pressure. There are lots of different ways to do that, but most famously people know about the air puff test and everybody hates it, but let me describe to you the alternative. The other way that we check the eye pressure is to put a yellow eye drop in your eyes and then bring a little blue light in the microscope over there in and actually touch the front part of your eye. So there are a lot of different things that we have to consider when we're trying to diagnose glaucoma. Factors like corneal thickness, age, ethnicity, and family history come into play. If you have a family history of glaucoma, it puts you at slightly higher risk to develop it yourself. So it's important to get your eyes checked regularly. So how do we treat glaucoma? It starts with all that testing that we talked about earlier, but then if we actually diagnose somebody with glaucoma, we usually start them on a regimen of eye drops. And a lot of times it just starts with one drop at bedtime. People respond differently to certain types of drops, and there are also different reasons that we can't use certain drops for each individual patient. So we'll start with one, usually, and if that doesn't work, sometimes we have to add in another, sometimes even add in another. But if you've been put on a few different eye drops for glaucoma, they're not working, a lot of times we'll send for a surgical evaluation. There are surgeries they can do, such as opening up the drainage system with a laser. They can also surgically install a shunt that would move fluid from the inside part of the eye into a different area they call bleb. So taking some of that fluid out of the eye will lower the pressure. There are lots of different products and procedures coming out for glaucoma all the time. So make sure to ask your doctor about the most recent research. So make sure to have your eyes checked regularly, including the air puff machine, to make sure that you'll never have to worry about glaucoma. This has been Eye Care in Focus. I'm Dr. Jordan Netzel. See you next time. If you have a question or a topic you'd like us to cover, make sure to send us a message on our Roberts-Philpott Eye Associates Facebook or Instagram page, or leave a comment below.